Good morning, everyone, and it is such a pleasure to welcome the minister here for her first official visit in this new capacity. I met with her in Lisbon and asked if she could come early in the year, and I'm delighted this worked out. We just had a wide-ranging and productive discussion about mutual security, economic, and development goals around the world. I look forward to many more such conversations. The enduring partnership between the United States and Spain is rooted in friendship and common values. We are not only bilateral partners, but regional and global as well, and united in a shared vision for a world that is peaceful, secure, and prosperous. Are we going to translate as we go? Are we going to do it in English?
No, I can't do it in English.
Okay. I wish I could do it in Spanish. We discussed the evolving situation in Lebanon, where Spanish soldiers have served in the peacekeeping operations of UNIFIL, the United Nations interim force in Lebanon, under a Spanish commander. We both share deep concerns about the influence of outside forces, and we hope to see a government emerge that will serve the interests of the people of Lebanon and sustain the independence and sovereignty of Lebanon. As NATO allies, we have worked closely and comprehensively to support the people of Afghanistan as they rebuild their country. Spanish troops are fighting the insurgency in Bagdis province and helping Afghan forces take lead responsibility for their own security. At the same time, civilian experts from Spain are helping Afghans grow food crops, train police forces, build roads that connect the country's far-flung rural communities. As global partners, we are working side by side to solve some of the most pressing problems. Both our countries are committed to fighting chronic hunger. Spain was one of the founding contributors to the World Bank's Global Agriculture and Food Security Program, which has already helped farmers boost productivity, encouraged investments in high-yield technologies, and helped improve nutrition for women and children. With its historical and lasting ties with Spanish-speaking countries, Spain is an especially important partner in this hemisphere. We are working together to help the people and governments of Central America ensure safety and build prosperity. After the United States, Spain is the second largest donor of development assistance in the region, including its work with a group of friends, a consortium of governments and organizations that fosters aid donations. It is actively working in Guatemala, El Salvador, Mexico, Colombia, so many other places. And I want to thank the government and the people of Spain, especially during what I know are challenging economic conditions, for all you are doing to help people get a better education, to help farmers, to help bring clean water, and so much more to advance development. But I would expect no less, because Spain is a great champion for human rights, not only in the Western Hemisphere, but around the world. I expressed our thanks for its work with the Catholic Church to secure the release of political prisoners and for Spain's ongoing efforts to encourage Cuba to release Alan Gross, who has been harshly and unfairly jailed for too long. I also appreciate all the work that Spain is doing in Haiti. They have worked with a wide range of international partners, donating food and medical supplies, providing doctors and nurses, and now working with us to ensure a legitimate, democratically elected government. Now, we have both been challenged by economic circumstances over the last 2 years, and Spain and the Spanish government under the leadership of Prime Minister Zapatero has taken decisive measures to reduce its debt, calm the markets, reassure other Eurozone partners that it's working toward financial stability. We know how important a healthy Spanish economy is. As we look toward the future, we see many, many challenges, but I feel much better and take great comfort in the fact that Spain and the United States will be working together.
Thank you. Thank you very much, dear Secretary of State, dear Hillary. Hello, good morning. Let me start by expressing my deep satisfaction of being here in the State Department and in this great country, in this great capital. I'm very grateful to be here and to have the opportunity to exchange views of many things that we have in common. We have a very fruitful exchange of ideas. Spain and the United States are close friends, are close allies. And we are close partners, bilaterally speaking, but also inside the European Union and also within the G20. We have to speak about so many issues, as the Secretary of State has explained. A more specific issue, our talk today have mirrored the quality and intensity of our relation. We have covered a broad range of topics in a very short time, almost an hour, but we have found a high degree of proximity, mutual understanding, and empathy. In the field of bilateral relations, we have touched upon issues of common interests and concerns, including the sharing of visits. I expressed my desire to receive her in Spain as soon as possible.
I expressed my desire to do so.
We are waiting for her. And trade and investment relations, consular justice, and honor force. So we have so many things now in which we are working. Palomares, Coso, and Caracosa issue. That has been mentioned during our meeting, but also security and cooperation in the field of defense has been part of our talks. In that sense, we have opted for extending the defense cooperation agreement, which expires the next February, introducing three technical adjustments. We also changed views of Afghanistan, reiterating our firm determination to achieve success in the process of transition, endorsed by the political leader for NATO in the Lisbon summit. We have speaking about also the current situation in the Maghreb. This is also very important. It's an area of strategic importance for Spain, but also for the United States. We have exchanged views on the Western Sahara, but Tunisia also has been part of our talks today, very important also for us. Also, we have spoke about Middle East, Lebanon, the new government of Lebanon, and how we can coordinate our position, our initiative, in order to get stabilization of the region. Spain and the United States also share a profound attachment to Latin America. Yeah, we have a strong historical ties and have become the two main investors in the continent. We share also a view about Central America, and we are planning to collaborate and coordinate our position because, there is a problem of security in the region in which we can coordinate some initiative with our different agency, cooperation agencies. So I think we will develop that opportunity to work intensively together. Also, we have spoke about Haiti. We are also worried about the situation of Haiti. And we want, to be together also in that process in order to recognize the result of the election, the recent election. So we are working together with some other countries in the region, Canada and Brazil, but also with the United Nations Mission and the European Union. I don't want to finish without mentioning also our desire for the candidacy of Mr. Moratino to the FAO. So, in the end, what I want to say is that we want to thank once again Secretary of State for your kindness and your commitment with Spain and with our country. For the future of our relationship. So I feel very happy to be here. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Time for two questions. First is Dave Gomes from Voice of America.
Madam Secretary, on Lebanon, do you anticipate being able to continue a normal political or aid relationship with a Lebanese government that's in which Hezbollah is believed to be calling the shots. I know outgoing Prime Minister Hariri described it as tantamount to a coup. What's your expectation for the future of our relations? And in our tradition of two-parters, there are some major demonstrations in Egypt today, and I'm wondering if there is concern in Washington about the stability of the Egyptian government, of course, a very valuable ally of the United States.
Well, David, we are watching the situation closely and carefully in Lebanon. We are monitoring new developments. As you know, the government formation is just beginning. A Hezbollah-controlled government would clearly have an impact on our bilateral relationship with Lebanon. Our bottom lines remain as they always have been. First, we believe that justice must be pursued and impunity for murder ended. We believe in Lebanon's sovereignty and an end to outside interference. So as we see what this new government does, we will judge it accordingly. With respect to Egypt, which, as your question implied, like many countries in the region, has been experiencing demonstrations. We know that they've occurred not only in Cairo, but around the country, and we're monitoring that very closely. We support the fundamental right of expression and assembly for all people, and we urge that all parties exercise restraint and refrain from violence. But our assessment is that the Egyptian government is stable and is looking for ways to respond to the legitimate needs and interests of the Egyptian people.
Secretary Clinton, regarding Tunisia, I wonder if you could elaborate a little bit more on the discussions you had today with Minister Jimenez, and also how likely do you see the possibility of the violence in Tunisia spreading to the rest of the region, and if you're planning to collaborate. And for Minister Jimenez, I'd like to know if you have expressed some disappointment to Secretary Clinton with the fact that Guantanamo is not being closed. Thank you very much.
Well, first, with respect to Tunisia, both the United States and Spain have a great interest in and commitment to Tunisia and the people of Tunisia. We each have our respective involvements that have been focused on our bilateral relations, but at this point in time, we are very much concerned about how we help the people of Tunisia make this transition. I have spoken to the foreign minister and to the interim prime minister, the prime minister as recently as this weekend. I'm encouraged by the direction that they are setting toward inclusive elections that will be held as soon as practicable. But there's a long way to go. As the minister and I were discussing, there's no experience, there's no institutional muscle memory about how you do this, and therefore Spain, United States, European Union, United Nations, other organizations around the world that want to see this transition successful and leading to a democratic, vibrant outcome are offering whatever help we can. In fact, Assistant Secretary for Near East Asian Affairs, Jeffrey Feltman, is in Tunisia right now meeting with a full cross-section of Tunisians to hear from them firsthand how they want to see this process unfold. So we're going to stay in very close touch, and I know that this will be on the agenda of the European Union on Monday when there's a full meeting. And before I turn to the minister, on Guantanamo, let me say how much President Obama and I appreciate what Spain has already done. We are absolutely committed to closing Guantanamo. It's turned out to be a little more challenging than we had hoped when we set that goal, but there is no doubt about our commitment. And the continuing support from friends like Spain will enable us to keep moving in that direction.
Thank you. If you don't mind, Secretary, I prefer speaking in Spanish in order to give a Spanish voice to the media about Guantanamo. España está apoyando al gobierno de Estados Unidos en su determinación de cerrar Guantánamo. Ya lo ha dicho la Secretaría de Estado y, desde luego, España, como otros países europeos, estamos apoyando al gobierno de Estados Unidos en esta intención tan firme y determinada de cerrar Guantánamo. Por eso España ha recibido a tres personas provenientes de Guantánamo y esperamos que continúen con todos los esfuerzos que están haciendo en el Congreso para poder conseguir su objetivo. Y para ello también está pidiendo un mayor apoyo por parte del resto de los países europeos para acoger a estos presos que están en Guantánamo. Por tanto, seguiremos apoyando a Estados Unidos como un país amigo, como un buen aliado, y también porque nos parece un buen propósito la oportunidad que tenemos de cerrar Guantánamo.
As the Secretary has said, this is something we discussed, and Spain is supporting the U.S. government in its decision to close Guantánamo. Spain and Europe support the United States in its firm decision in this regard, and for that reason, Spain has already received three detainees from Guantánamo. We hope that the U.S. will continue its good efforts with the U.S. Congress in this regard, and there will be continued and greater efforts from European countries to help to this end. We're doing this because we are friends, we are allies, and we believe that this is a good decision. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.